Do you want to know how to do 6 deals in 1 month? Tim Gola did it, and we'll break it down next on Agent Hacks. We have got one of our newest rock star agents on the show this week, Tim Gola, fellow Devon Prep alumni, if you know what that means. If not, don't worry about it. The reason we have him on is he had a monster month that any realtor would be psyched to have a year with this many sales, let alone 1 month. 6 deals in 1 month. Tim, how'd you do it? What were some of the keys?
Absolutely. So I started 4 months ago. And the first 3 months were a little bumpy. I think I went, you know, just under 3 months without one offer submitted. I was nervous. I started to question myself. But what I did, I just focused on this. I get this from Tom. You know, it's the small things, your day in and your day out. You know, I was like, what's going on? You know, I feel like I'm doing all the right things. But I took a step back and I reevaluated. I'm like, just to keep doing the little things right. So on top of my, you know, day-to-day 2 hours of calls a day, which, you know, has also on the backside, it's helped me keep that momentum. You know what I mean? And you always say this, when the motivation isn't there, the discipline takes over, right? So on top of that, I just hammered scripting. I was wordy and I was just kind of trying to use my personality to get things done. And I needed to, you know, sit back and reevaluate. And Josh, you know, our sales manager, was really influential there in guiding me on how to correct the things I needed to do. And, you know, thank God I was able to listen and implement that.
Well, you said a couple things there. One is you implement it, which is where most people get hung up. They know what they're supposed to do, and they don't actually do it. But I also heard I practice my scripts, right? Most people don't practice their scripts. I heard that I reevaluated, and there was a ton of effort. I mean, if you looked at Tim's metrics and his numbers, the call numbers were there, the emails were there, the CRM looked great, text messages were there. So I appreciate that you said, well, you had the meeting with yourself, right? It wasn't anybody else. And I do this all the time. I mean, you have to embrace failure in a lot of cases, because then you can learn from it. So you had a killer month. I mean, enough production for 3 or 4 months for most agents. So you mentioned what you're doing to keep the momentum going. So now that you've had this breakthrough, how are you working towards the next breakthrough? Because that's what everyone wants to know.
Well, I had the moment, you know, I got my 6th deal under contract, and, you know, I started to celebrate a little bit, right?
Which is okay, by the way. You should celebrate. I don't want to say that's wrong.
Huge believer in a celebration, but a quick one, right?
Yes, yes.
And then, you know, I did my celebration, and I said, this is the moment you need to ramp it up. Not take your foot off the gas. You know, as a new guy, I've heard from a lot of agents that are more experienced that said, when you have a hot month, a lot of new agents make that mistake of taking your foot off the gas, and this is a momentum business. And I truly believe that, yeah, I saw it. You know, I got 2 deals under contract, started feeling good about, you know, what I was offering the clients. And it's a snowball. And, you know, I'd be an idiot not to just keep pushing that thing down the hill.
Well, and Grant Cardone says this all the time, if you ever read the 10X rule, where it's momentum's like a fire, right? And once you get the fire going, you got to keep building the fire. You got to keep putting on the wood. And that's making more calls, meeting more people, setting more appointments. So I think that's probably the most important thing people want to hear is that it's momentum's hard to get. Easier to keep, but then once you take your foot off the gas, you'll feel that real quick. And that's, you know, that's the tough thing about sales or any business, really, if you're in any sort of entrepreneurial business. So killer month, you practiced your scripts, you reevaluated what was working and what wasn't. You're continuing with the daily actions that got you there in the first place. So any advice for someone watching this where they're maybe in a little bit of a slump or they're not feeling great about what's going on in their business? What should they be doing now so that they can have the same kind of results you just had and keep them going for the long term? Because I know that's the game plan and the focus.
Yep. Like you said, it's long term. You know, short term thinking can get you in a heap of trouble. You have to, you know, think long term and just keep doing. You have to be willing to lose too. I mean, this is a very tough business. It's very competitive, and you have to be able to get served a couple slices of humble pie every now and then. And like you said, with the hacky sack metaphor, you know, you don't want to be that hacky sack when you hit the ground, you just splat. You know, you want to bounce up, and you need to be tenacious, and you need to have thick skin. And you just need to keep doing the daily little things, and it'll happen. It'll happen. It may not happen overnight. You know, I was sitting there for 3 months being like, what is going on? But you do little things, and you believe in yourself, and you keep working hard. I mean, that's pretty much it. It's not too complicated.
Well, and the one thing, Tim hasn't said this here, he's been coachable. He was willing to accept feedback and from himself, from you know our sales manager, and he acted on it, and that's why he's seeing the results. Because, look, I've had to take feedback, humble pie, take the loss, all that stuff. That happens to everybody, right? Yeah. Me included, everyone out there. You ask the biggest achievers out there, they've mastered failing, and they bounce back quick. Yep. And that's the key here. So great stuff. I mean, there's a lot to take away from this episode. I'm taking mental notes here of things we can all work on together. We're going to put Tim's info up here. You want to reach out to him direct, feel free. Otherwise, we'll be back next week.